In the classroom, each child was asked about their dreams when they grew up. This little girl said when she grew up she wanted to be a famous person. Hearing that, the teacher laughed and said this was also his wish. This rich boy stood up and said he wanted to be a great businessman. Any profession was fine, but it was important to be big. The teacher nodded and seemed very pleased with the boy's answer. When it was Nan's turn, the teacher immediately changed his expression. Because Nan stood up and said, "I want to be a poor man." Hearing that, everyone laughed at him, because he seemed to have done it. Everyone had a calculator when they went to school, only Nan didn't have one. But he continued, "Because my dad said just have courage, confidence. Don't fight, study hard, no matter how poor you are, you will receive respect." After listening, everyone just quietly looked at him, and no one laughed at him anymore. When the teacher's fountain pen accidentally fell, Nan immediately picked it up. However, the teacher's mood immediately became unsatisfied. The teacher scolded angrily and didn't want Nan to be close to his as if there had bacteria on Nan's body. Even after Nan touched the fountain pen, he immediately used a handkerchief to wipe it off many times. Seeing that, Nan could only smile to hide his embarrassment. After school, the rich boy was showing off his newest toy. But when Nan went up to see it, he pushed Nan away. The rich boy holding a toy dog walked in front of a fat girl and started scolding her. Actually, the children's unintentional malice needed no reason at all. Just when the fat girl didn't know what to do, Nan stepped forward to help. But the fat girl still ran away. When Nan was punished for not having sneakers, the fat girl appeared and shyly said that she wanted to be punished with him. Hearing that, Nan was a little scared. The next day while going out with his father, Nan saw the toy dog and wanted his father to buy it. However, his father couldn't afford to buy it. Nan still wouldn't put the toy down. With no other choice, his father had to beat Nan's ass. At this point, Nan just put it down. After returning home, Nan's father named Ming felt extremely sorry for Nan. So he wanted to go pick up a good pair of sneakers to comfort Nan. But while he was looking, he suddenly saw that the old television next to him had a signal. He picked up the TV, and he was completely unaware that there was a flying saucer starting up in front of him. After that, the flying saucer quickly flew away, and left only a green ball. After receiving this gift, Nan felt very happy. He quickly brought it to school to show off to his classmate named San. However, this incident was accidentally seen by the rich boy. This boy sarcastically said this was just trash. He even mocked Nan's father as the garbage collector. Hearing that, Nan was extremely angry to throw the green ball away, and was about to rush to hit the other boy. But unexpectedly, there was a fat guy weighing 150 kilograms who appeared behind Nan. The fat boy grabbed Nan's hand and threw him away. After knowing that Nan got into a fight with his classmates at school, Ming was very angry and was about to hit Nan. At first, he held the wooden stick, but because it was too big, he put down. Then he picked up the clothes hanger again, but this was too small. Finally, he used newspaper to roll it into a whip, but he didn't mercilessly hit Nan. At this time, suddenly there was thunder and lightning. Ming had to close the window. But it didn't seem to have any effect. After that, Ming taught his son through advice and sat down to sew his son's uniform. At this time, Nan saw the green ball that had changed into a different shape in the cupboard. This made him startle. However, Ming thought that Nan was causing trouble. So he put Nan in the cupboard, causing him to panic even more. But after that, the ball showed strange images. It turned out to be a toy dog from space. Nan was delighted to see this high-tech toy named CJ7. When going to school, he brought CJ7 with him and told it to fight the aggressive dog. After that, CJ7 knocked out the dog with just a few moves. Nan happily walked up the street. In the toilet, Nan told CJ7 that he wanted to get 100 points in the test. After CJ7 did something, it immediately took out a high-tech glasses. This glasses could launch a surveillance device with just a small fly. As expected, Nan easily got 100 points. But when the teacher discovered something, Nan immediately turned to throw the glasses away. Unexpectedly, all the teacher's teeth also fell out. After that, during PE class, Nan got a pair of divine sneakers. He jumped to a height of 10 meters in one jump. When he got on the treadmill, he even broke it. While in the water, he could also swim easily thanks to these shoes. On the pitch, Nan only needed a light kick to ruin the whole goal. After that, a group of teachers chased, Nan just stood on tiptoe and flew into the air. When Nan was about to land, he suddenly woke up. It turned out all of this was just his dream. But when seeing CJ7 in the corner, Nan was surprised and happy. He swore that he should get 100 points this time. After that, he went to the alley where the ferocious dog was. He confidently told CJ7 to hit the dog, but he didn't expect CJ7 to lose so badly. They were extremely bored walking down the street. Nan went to the toilet and said he wanted to get 100 points. Then he told CJ7 to bring out the treasure. Although it used all its strength, there was only a pile of its poop. Seeing that, Nan was a bit suspicious, but still brought it to the classroom. However, when the time was running out, this pile of poop was still unresponsive. The rich boy next to him saw this and immediately threw it on Nan's head. Indeed, it was just an ordinary pile of poop. This made Nan very angry, so he put CJ7's face into the water. However, this activated CJ7's defense system. At night, after Nan and his father slept soundly, CJ7 sent out light waves to the old electric fan. The copper wire inside was slowly reconnecting. It turned out it also had superpowers. After that, the top of its head suddenly emitted light. The next day, Ming saw the electric fan suddenly working. He was very suspicious. After that, he asked about his son's test results. Nan quickly gave the test to him, and hurriedly ran out of the house. When Ming saw his son's test scores, he was very surprised. When Nan went to school, he was bullied by the rich boy. Seeing that, CJ7 quickly ran away, and it ran into a bush. After that, Nan started beating the rich boy and grabbing his collar. At this moment, there was a large hand suddenly grabbing Nan. That was the fat boy. Just as the fat guy was about to hit Nan, there was also a bigger hand appearing behind him. This fat girl threw the fat boy 40 meters away. After that, the fat guy threw out a water barrel, but the fat girl caught it. She even squeezed the barrel that caused water to splash. After that, the fat boy quickly rushed forward and attacked her. However, the girl was still unharmed and directly lifted the fat boy. She even squeezed him and made him suffocate. After that, she even hugged Nan and looked at him with loving eyes. At this time, the teacher came and punished everyone to stand in the middle of the schoolyard. After the teacher left, CJ7 just came out from the bushes. People told it to make all kinds of expressions from happy, angry to sad. But eventually, because CJ7 gave off too much chaotic mood, the atmosphere immediately became lively, and people started talking and laughing again. The kids got rid of the previous conflicts. Meanwhile, Ming went around telling everyone that his son got 100 points. However, the boss said that Ming's son cheated. And he also pointed out evidence that the scores on the test were corrected. Hearing that, Ming got a little annoyed and said, "If you say bad things about my son again, I'll hit you." This made his boss so angry that he slapped him. When the boss was about to fight again, Ming stopped him then ran away. When Ming just got home and asked Nan, Nan said he only fixed his score and didn't cheat. Out of anger, Ming took away CJ7 and scolded Nan. And Ming also said that if Nan could get 60 points, he would give it back to him. Ming sadly looked at his son slowly walking away. Although he was very angry, he couldn't let his son go hungry. He brought the lunchbox to school, but didn't dare to enter into, so he asked the teacher to deliver it for his son. To earn money, Ming went to the construction site to ask his boss to go back to work. Then the boss pushed him inside the office. The boss rummaged through his pocket and brought out an envelope. And he even apologized for his loss of control. When receiving the envelope, Ming smiled even brighter than usual. He worked harder. Unexpectedly, two iron gas cylinders suddenly fell down. Therefore, the rope quickly moved and wrapped around Ming's leg. He wanted to fasten his seat belt, but it was too late. Ming tried to cling to the nylon net. The worker next to him discovered him and immediately reached out to save him. Just when their hands were about to touch each other, the nylon net broke, so Ming fell down. At this point, Nan was given the test and he got 65 points. But then the teacher rushed into the classroom and took Nan to the hospital. However, Nan's father didn't pass the surgery and he died. After all the doctors left the room, CJ7 crawled out. It started to move and then emitted a light. Suddenly, Ming's arm was starting to return to its original state. It turned out CJ7 used all its strength to treat Ming. At night, Nan cried alone and was so tired that he fell asleep. When waking up the next morning, he found his father lying next to him. Nan thought it looked like he was seeing a ghost in broad daylight, but then hugged Ming tightly. Suddenly there was a noise in the backpack. CJ7 was slowly crawling out. It wasn't as active as before, it was just lying on the bed, because it was exhausted. By the time the energy ball on the top of its head fell, CJ7 had turned into a stuffed animal. Ming and Nan tried many ways, but CJ7 still couldn't recover. Since CJ7 turned into a stuffed animal, Nan had closed his eyes and counted 3 times. In the hope that when opening his eyes, he would be able to see CJ7's original state. This day, he repeated the same movement as usual, but the stuffed animal still didn't react. He was helpless lying on the grass. Suddenly, Nan saw a spaceship coming, he immediately chased it. After that, a lot of CJ7 came out from the spaceship. The story had a happy ending. The father's words throughout the film. Although we are poor, we must not do wrong, we must not steal. Things that don't belong to us, we can't take away. You must study hard so that you can become a useful person in the future. These sayings were also the sayings that Stephen Chow's mother taught him when he was young. And he also wanted to continue passing on these sayings. In this movie, we can see Stephen Chow Sing Chi also wanted to say goodbye to his acting career. Nan Flew to the Sky and CJ7's expression mentioned his two films, Kung Fu Hustle and King of Comedy, respectively. This was also the last movie in which he played the lead role. Will we have the opportunity to see him act again in the future, even if only as a guest?